subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. If you are attempting NEET, then you must watch this video till the end, because in this particular video we are going to discuss the most important questions of NEET for physics subject. Okay, so now let's begin the video. So I'll be asking questions as well as I'll be even telling you the answers. So after asking each and every question, so you can just try to tell the correct answer if you can. Okay, so coming to first, let's discuss about units and measurements chapter. First question is, the kilowatt hour is a unit of dash. Okay, I'm repeating the question. The kilowatt hour is a unit of dash. Options are electric power, electric charge, force, energy. The kilowatt hour is a unit of energy, electric power, electric charge, or force. These are the four options. The correct answer is option A, energy. Okay, so the kilo hour is a unit of energy. Okay, so coming to next important question, the dimension formula of kinetic energy is same as that of dash. Okay, the dimension formula of kinetic energy is same as that of dash. Options are momentum, work, force, pressure. The dimensional formula of kinetic energy is same as that of force, work, momentum, and pressure. The correct answer is work. So the dimensional formula of kinetic energy is equal to the work. Okay, so coming to next important question, which of the following sets cannot enter into the list of fundamental quantities in any system of units? I'm repeating the question. Which of the following sets cannot enter into the list of fundamental quantities in any system of units? Options are length, mass, velocity. Option B, length, time, velocity. Option C, length, time, mass. Option D, mass, time, velocity. I'm repeating the question as well as options. Which of the following sets cannot enter into the list of fundamental quantities in any system of units? Options are option A, length, mass, velocity. Option B, length, time, velocity. Option C, length, time, and mass. And option D is mass, time, and velocity. So the correct answer is length, time, and velocity. So coming to next question, in a certain system of units, one unit of time is 5 seconds, one unit of mass is 20 kgs, and unit of length is 10 m. In this system, one unit of power will correspond to dash. I'm repeating the question. In a certain system of units, one unit of time is 5 seconds, one unit of mass is 20 kgs, and a unit of length is 10 m. In this system, one unit of power will correspond to dash. Options are, option A is 16 watts, option B is 1 by 16 watts, option C is 25 watts, and option D is 40 watts. I'm repeating the options. Option A is 16 watts, option B is 1 by 16 watts, option C is 25 watts, and option D is 40 watts. Correct answer is 16 watts. How did we get 16 watts? Is the formula of P is ml square into T minus Q. Okay, so if we substitute the values into this formula, we'll get the answer as 16 watts. So coming to next question, the dimensional representation of Planck's constant is identical to that of dash. I'm repeating the question. The dimensional representation of Planck's constant is identical to that of dash. Options are power, linear momentum, angular momentum. I'm repeating the options. Options are power, linear momentum, angular momentum, and the correct answer is option C, angular momentum. And next question is, if the units of m and l are quadrupled, then the units of torque becomes dash. I'm repeating the question. If the moments of M and L are quadrupled, then the units of torque Q becomes dash. Options are 16 times, 64 times, 8 times, 4 times. I'm repeating the options. 16 times, 64 times, 8 times, 4 times. And the correct answer is option B, which is 64 times. Coming to the next question, which of the following is not a unit of time? Which of the following is not a unit of time? Options are solar year, leap year, tropical year, and light year. I'm repeating the options: solar year, leap year, tropical year, and light year. Correct answer is light year. Light year is not a unit of time. Now let's discuss the most important questions from motion in one dimension. Okay, so coming to first question, a car travels first 1/3 of the distance AB at 30 kilometers per hour. Last 1/3 of the distance at 24 kilometers per hour. Its average speed in kilometers per hour in whole journey is how much? I'm repeating the question. A car traveled first 1/3 of the distance at 30 kilometers per hour, next 1/3 of the distance at 40 kilometers per hour, last 1/3 of the distance at 24 kilometers per hour. So what is the average distance per hour is the question. Options are 40, 35, 30, 28. I'm repeating the options: 40, 35, 30, 28. And the correct answer is option C, which is 30 kilometers. Average speed in kilometers per hour is 30 kilometers. Okay. Next question. A particle goes A to M. So A is a point, M is a point. So a particle is traveling from A to M with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour and M to B, A, M, B. Okay. So it's traveling M to B at the speed of 50 kilometers per hour. If MB is equal to 5 AM, the average speed in kilometer per hour for the whole journey is how much? I'm repeating the question. A particle goes from A to M with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour and M to B with a speed of 50 kilometers per hour. If MB is equal to 5 AM, then the average speed in the kilometers per hour for the entire whole journey is how much is the question. Okay, options are option A, 40 kilometers per hour, option B, 35 kilometers per hour, and option C is 45 kilometers per hour. I'm repeating the options: 40 kilometers per hour, 35 kilometers per hour, 45 kilometers per hour. Okay, so the correct answer is option C, which is 45 kilometers per hour. So, and coming to the next important question, a stone falls freely from the rest and total distance covered by it in the last second of motion is equals to the distance covered by it in the first 3 seconds of its motion. The stone remains in the air for how many seconds is the question. I'm repeating the question. The stone falls freely from the rest and the total distance covered by it in the last second is equal to the motion equals to the first 3 seconds. So the stone remains in the air for how many seconds? The options are 4 seconds, 5 seconds, 6 seconds, and 7 seconds. The correct answer is 6 seconds. So the stone is remained in the air for 6 seconds. So now let's discuss the chapter waves. Okay. The power of the sound from the speaker is raised from 10 mW to 500 mW. What is the power increased in decibels as compared to the initial original power? Okay, the question is the power of the speaker is increased from 10 mW to 500 mW. So what is the power increased in decibels is the question. What is the power increased in decibels as compared to the original initial power is the question. Options are 1.6 decibels, 5.0 decibels, 16 decibels, 16.9 decibels. I am repeating the question. 1.6 decibels, 5.0 decibels, 16.0 decibels and 16.9 decibels. The correct answer is the power of increase in decibels from the initial stage is 16.9 decibels. Okay. Next question is, consider a stretched string under tension and fixed at both the points. If the tension is doubled and the cross-sectional area halved, then the frequency becomes dashed. I'm repeating the question. Consider the stretched string under tension and fixed at both the ends. If the tension is doubled and the cross-sectional area is halved, then the frequency becomes dash. Options are twice, thrice, half, four times. I'm repeating the options. Twice, thrice, half, four times. And the correct answer is twice. It becomes twice. Let's discuss important questions of electric charge and fields. Coming to first important question, an electric dipole is situated in non-uniform electric field. It may experience dash. Okay. I'm repeating the question. An electric dipole is situated in non-uniform electric field. So what will it experience is the question. Okay. Options are, it may experience only force, it may experience only couple, it may experience only resultant force and couple, and the option D is all of the above. I'm repeating the options. It may experience only force, it may experience only couple, it may experience resultant force and couple, and it may, option D is, it may experience all of the above. The correct answer is, it experiences all of the above. It, there will be force, there will be resultant force and couple, as well as there will be only couple as well. Okay. So the next question is, two bodies are charged by rubbing one against each other. During this process, one becomes positively charged while other becomes negatively charged. Then what will happen? Then what will be the case is the question. I'm repeating the question. Two bodies are charged by rubbing against each other. While this procedure, one body is completely positively charged and other is negatively charged, then what will be the situation? Options are, mass of each body remains unchanged, mass of each body changes marginally, mass of each body changes slightly, but the total mass of the body remains unchanged. I'm repeating the options. The options are, mass of the body remains changed, mass of the body remains unchanged, mass of the body changes marginally, and the last option is, mass of the each body changes slightly, but the total mass remains the same. I'm repeating the options. Mass of the body remains changed, remains unchanged, remains marginally changed, and the last option is, mass of the body changes slightly, but the total mass remains the same. The correct answer is option D, which is, so in this situation, what happens is, mass of the each body changes slightly, but the total mass remains the same. It will be unchanged. Now let's discuss from the chapter vectors. Okay, so coming to vectors, first important question is, the magnitude of the given vector with the n points is 4, minus 4, 0 and minus 2, minus 2, 0 must be what? I'm repeating the question. The magnitude of each vector with the n points 4, minus 4, 0, minus 2, minus 2, 0 must be what? Options are 6, 2 under root 10, 4, 4 under root 8. I'm repeating the options. 6, 2 under root 10, 4, 4 under root 10. The correct answer is, it will be 2 under root 10. Okay, the magnitude of the given vector, when we solve the problem, the answer will be 2 under root 10. Okay. Next question is, the angle made by the vector A is equal to I plus J with x axis is dash. I'm repeating the question. The angle made with the vector A is equal to I plus J with x axis is dash. Options are 90 degrees, 45 degrees, 22 degrees, 35 degrees. I'm repeating the options. 90 degrees, 45 degrees, 22 degrees, 45 degrees. Options are 90 degrees, 40 degrees, 45 degrees, 50 degrees. I'm repeating the options: 90 degrees, 40 degrees, 45 degrees, 50 degrees. And the correct answer is 45 degrees. Next question: the resultant of two vectors having magnitude 2 and 3 is 1. What is the magnitude of their cross product? I'm repeating the question. The resultant of two vectors having the magnitude 2 and 3 is 1. What is the magnitude of their cross product? Options are 1, 2, 3, 0. I'm repeating the options 1, 2, 3, 0. And the correct answer is once we cross product, the magnitude will be 0. So now let's discuss about motion in two dimensions. The important questions are, a cricketer can throw a ball to a maximum horizontal distance of 100 meters. With the same effort, he throws the ball vertically upwards. The maximum height attained by the ball is how much? I'm repeating the question. A cricketer can throw a ball maximum horizontally up to 100 meters. How much distance can he throw if he threw the ball in a vertical direction is the question. Like, what will be the height if he threw the same ball in the vertical direction? Options are 100 meters, 200 meters, 50 meters, 60 meters. I'm repeating the options 100 meters, 200 meters, 50 meters and 60 meters. Answer will be 50 meters. Okay. Coming to the next question, one fielder throws a ball and in 4 seconds it reaches the another player. So the point of the projection reached by the ball above the point of the projection will be dash. I'm repeating the question. One fielder throws a ball in 4 seconds and it reaches the other player. So the maximum height reached by the ball above the point of the projection will be how much? Options are 10 meters, 20 meters, 30 meters, 35 meters. I'm repeating the options 10 meters, 20 meters, 30 meters, 35 meters. Once we substitute the values in the formula, we get the answer as 20 meters. Next question is, the speed of the boat is 5 kilometers per hour in still water. It crosses a river of width 1 kilometer along with the shortest possible path in 15 minutes. The velocity of the water is dash. I'm repeating the question. The speed of the water is 5 kilometers per hour in still water. It crosses a river of width 1 kilometer along with the shortest possible path in just 15 minutes. And the velocity of the river water is how much? The options are 1 kilometer per hour, 2 kilometer per hour, 3 kilometer per hour and 4 kilometers per hour. The velocity of the river water will be 3 kilometers per hour. Now let's discuss from Newton's law of motion. Okay, the first question is, in a given arrangement, strings and pulleys are light and all surfaces are frictionless. Assuming at t is equal to 0, system is released from the rest. Find the speed of the block A at t is equal to 2 seconds. I'm repeating the question. In the given arrangement, strings and pulleys are light and all the surfaces are frictionless. Assuming at t is equal to 0, system is released from rest. Find the speed of the block A at t is equal to 2 seconds. Options are 8 meters per second, 9 meters per second, 10 meters per second, 11 meters per second. Options are 8 meters, 9 meters, 10 meters and 11 meters per second. The correct answer is option C, which is 10 meters per second. Next question is, when a particle moves in a vertical circle, what are the possibilities? I'm repeating the question. When a particle moves in a vertical circle, what are the possibilities? Options are, it has constant radial and tangential accelerations. Second option is, it has variable tangential and radial accelerations. Option C is, it has only constant radial but not tangential accelerations. The correct answer is, it has variable tangential and radial accelerations. Next question. A rocket of mass 120 kgs is fired in the gravity free space. It ejects gases with velocity of 600 meters per second at the rate of 1 kg per second. So what will be the initial acceleration of the rocket? I'm repeating the question. A rocket of mass 120 kgs is fired in the gravity free space. It ejects gases with a velocity 600 meters per second at the rate of 1 kg per second. What will be the initial acceleration of the rocket? Options are 1 meter per second square, 2 meters per second square, 5 meters per second square, 10 meters per second square. Options are 1, 2, 5, 10. The correct answer is it will be 5 meters per second square. Discuss about magnetic effects of current. The first question is the strength of the magnetic field at the point R near a long straight current carrying wire is B. Let us assume that it's B. Okay, the field at a distance R by 2 will be how much? I'm repeating the question. If the strength of the magnetic field at the point R near a long straight current carrying wire is B, then what will be the field at a distance R by 2? Options are B by 2, B by 4, 2B, 6B. I'm repeating the options. B by 2, B by 4, 2B and 6B. The correct answer is 2B. Question, what is the correct statement regarding cyclotron? Options are charged particle accelerated only between 2Ds. Next option is charged particle accelerated throughout the circular path. I'm repeating the options as well as question. Select the correct statement regarding cyclotron. Options are charged particle accelerated only between 2Ds. Option B is charged particles accelerated throughout the circular path. B is correct. Charged particles will be accelerated throughout its circular path. Next question is a charged particle moves through a magnetic field directed perpendicular to its direction of motion. So which of the following quantities of the particle will not change? He's asking what are the quantities of the particles which will be constant, which will be unchanged. Okay, I'm repeating the question as well. A charged particle moves through the magnetic field directed perpendicular to its direction of motion. So what will be the quantity which will be unchanged? Options are momentum, speed, velocity, all of the above. I'm repeating the options. Momentum, speed, velocity, all of the above. And the correct answer is speed. Speed will not change in this situation. Now let's discuss from the chapter magnetism. So coming to the first question, due to the small magnetic intensity at a distance x in the end on position is 9 gauss. What is the intensity at the distance x by 2 on broadside on position? I'm repeating the question. Due to the small magnet intensity at the distance x in the end of the position is 9 gauss. What will be the intensity at a distance x by 2 on broadside of the position? Options are 9 gauss, 4 gauss, 36 gauss, 38 gauss. I'm repeating the options 9, 6, 36, 38. And the correct answer is 36 gauss. And the next question is, which of the following magnetic material is temperature dependent? Okay, so friends, this kind of questions you should be really careful about, because try to read the question carefully. Sometimes they will ask which of the magnetic material is not temperature dependent. Such kind of questions will be asked, so make sure you read the question carefully. Okay, so coming to this question, which of the following magnetic material is temperature dependent? And the options are paramagnetism, diamagnetism. And the correct answer is paramagnetism. So paramagnetism is temperature dependent. So now let's discuss about electromagnetic induction. And the question is, if the kinetic energy of a particle is increased by 16 times, the percentage change In the de Broglie wavelength of the particle is how much? I'm repeating the question. If the kinetic energy of the particle is increased by 16 times, then the percentage of the change in the de Broglie wavelength of the particle is how much? Options are 25%, 70%, 60%, 68%. Options are 25%, 75%, 60%, 68%. And the correct answer is 75%. So the percentage change in the wavelength will be of 75%. Now let's discuss about the chapter from gravitation. And the first question is the height at which the acceleration due to the gravity becomes g by g in the terms of r. Then the radius of the earth will be how much is the question. I'm repeating the question. The height at which the acceleration due to the gravitation becomes g by g. Then here we are asked to find the radius of the earth. Okay. And the options are 2r, r by 2, r by 3, r by root 2. I'm repeating the options. 2r, r by 2, r by 3, r by root 2. And once we substitute the formula, we'll get the answer as 2r. And the formula is g is equal to gh by r plus h whole square. We just need to substitute and solve this to get the answer 2r. The next question is a satellite of the sun is in circular orbit around the sun, midway between the sun and the earth. Then what is the correct answer? Okay, I'm repeating the question. The satellite of the sun is in the circular orbit around the sun, midway between the sun and the earth. Then choose the correct option. And the options are the period of the satellite is nearly 229 days. Second option is the period of the satellite is nearly 129 days. And third option is the period of the satellite is nearly 365 days. Here we are asked to find the correct statement, whether the period of the satellite is nearly 229 days or 129 days or 365 days. And we know the correct answer, which is 129 days. So hope you found this video useful. If you want similar kind of videos, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you have any doubts, then also you can feel free to comment in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos, so that you will be notified whenever I make a new neat video. And also don't forget to like and share this video, so that it inspires and motivates me to make more and more similar kind of videos for you people. Thanks for watching till the end. And